Hello, welcome students. Welcome my class 8 students to your geography class. And today we are going to have a quick revision of population density. That means how the population is divided in different regions according to the sources, according to the surrounding of that place. So there are certain factors which will affect the population of that place, population density of that place. That means whether the population is more at that place, whether the population is moderate at that place, or whether the population is very less or scattered here and there at a place. It depends upon the resources available in and around that area. So there are certain factors which will affect the population density of a place. One will be in positive manner and one will be in negative manner. So we have used the term encouraging factors, that means which will result in more population at a place, and discouraging factor, that means which will have very less population at that place. That means because of these factors, there are certain place or a certain area will have less population. So we will be revising or we will be discussing them one by one today. So first we will be going for the positive factors which encourage the settlement of any area. Encouraging factors, we have used the term over here, is encouraging factors. So we will be discussing one by one, and I will be writing here on my board, and I want you people to make a note. So encouraging factors, what all can be the encouraging factors? So if you apply this to your practical life, for example, if you go for a metropolitan cities, for a metropolitan city like you can say Mumbai, Delhi, or Chennai, then your Kolkata, why the population at these places is very, means it is in so many people live, the population density, why the population density over these places are high? Because of all the resources available there. That means whatever a person needs for his livelihood, whether it can be in place, or whether it can be in terms of climate, whether it can be in terms of resources like food availability, whether it can be in terms of financial help, work help, job opportunity. Why the people from, you can say, village area move to cities in search of job, in search of good lifestyle, in search of standard living style, in search of job? That means in order to earn money, and ultimately if they earn money, they will be able to fulfill their needs, or you can say the requirements which is needed, as well as after meeting their basic requirements, they will be going towards a luxurious life. So this is only possible at a place when all the resources are available, whatever is needed by a human being. So the first, you can say, the encouraging factor, which is, you can say, is the land. If you refer your book, that is, it is written over there, the fertile land, the soil, or you can say the plain area, not a rugged land. A plain area, we live in a plain area like UP, it is a plain area. So here it is encouraging factor, it should be plain area. First is plain area, or you can say the fertile The next factor is the climate of that place. That means the climate of that place should be suitable for the human being to survive, to adapt, or to make them comfortable in that area. It should not be very cold, it should not be very hot, it should have a moderate climate, it should experience all type of seasons. So you can say the other factor we can write over here is climate. The other factor we can write is climate. Then the third factor, you can go for the resources. Resources now in terms of what? If you say resources in terms of what? Resources available. Now resources can be in many terms. For example, the availability of all the mineral resources, all the food crops, or you can say in such a way you can have the world resources. Now number four, you can go for job opportunities. You can go for job opportunities. Then number four, that is in a city there will be industrial areas, there will be so many factories, there will be so many work available for the people. They can earn money from these resources and they can earn a lifestyle, they can get a good standard lifestyle. So what word has, one more word has come, that is industrial area. Industrial area. Then you can say this one, plain, then climate, then resources, then job opportunities, industrial areas. Then you can say culturally developed, that means the society of that place. People should be cooperative, it should be culturally developed. Culturally developed. So there, these are all, you can say a quick, you can say the points which should be on the tip of your tongue, which encourages the settlement of any area. Then next you can say, for example, plain area, fertile soil. Here only you can add agricultural facility. No place over here. So I am writing agriculture because these all points are linked to each other. So here you can write agricultural facility should be there, which supports, and facility of water, facility of irrigation. So all these come under this heading, plain area. If the land will have fertile soil, ultimately that will support a good agriculture, and good agriculture means proper irrigation, a proper climate, a proper rainfall. So then presence of this one, resources. Here you can say resources can be in terms of mineral resources. You can add the word mineral resources over here. Resources, mineral resources help in all the it is necessary for our lifestyle. So mineral resources can be in terms of fossil fuels, that can be in terms of petroleum, coal, anything, it can come under this. Then one more point which we have missed over here is transport system. One of the very encouraging factors is the transport system. If transport system at a place is not well developed, people will not be able to explore themselves or explore the things available in that area. So a good transportation is must so that people can travel from one place to another. Transport should be available. A better, a well-developed, like I have in a, just before starting this topic, I have we have discussed about metropolitan cities, and what is the best quality of these metropolitan cities, that the transport system is highly advanced over there. Now the next thing you can say, discouraging factors. Discouraging factors will go in negative terms, that means which will cause a less or low population density at a place. This will be in negative sense. So discouraging factor, the first one you can say climate. Suppose if you are living in Uttar Pradesh, we are living in Uttar Pradesh, we are experiencing all type of climate. That means we have summer season, we have rainy season, we have winter, autumn, spring, we have the best, all the climates we experience over here. But if you are sent to, suppose for example, you will be laughing if I say, if you are sent to Antarctic region, the coldest region, if you are sent Arctic region, will you be able to live there? Will you be able to adapt yourself in that situation? No, it will be very difficult for us to live there. So same way, that is why Antarctica and Arctic, these are colder regions. Not only this, many colder regions are having very less population because of the excessive cold climate over there. And same follows for the hot climate also. For example, desert area. Desert area is also not having that much population in comparison to the high population populated areas. That means wherever all the facilities are there, wherever the climate is good, in that area, whatever population you will find in comparison to that desert area will be having very less. Why it will be having very less? Because of the severe hot climate. So you can say severe cold, and you can say also hot climate. Severe cold and hot climate, very high temperature will also be a discouraging factor for the population density. The next is, you can say, the facility of agriculture, the rugged terrain, mountainous areas. These areas will also not have a very high dense population density. So you can say the height matters a lot. The height, in bracket you can write altitude, that means height. The more the height, that means if it is a mountainous area, it will have very less population in comparison to the plain area. So our third point is, the third point or the third discouraging factor is the drought prone area. And one more I will add over here, that is poor soil. These two points we will be discussing together, poor soil or the agricultural facility present at that area. So drought conditions can be because of very high temperature. If the rainfall pattern differs in that area, it is having very less rainfall. So it will be affecting that place or that place agricultural pattern. And if the soil is poor, suppose if the soil is not fertile, if the people are not able to do agricultural over there, ultimately it will also discourage the people to settle down area, because they may not feed their family, they may not earn a living from the, they are basically dependent on agriculture, if their occupation is agriculture, or if they will not produce in that area, the people, those who do not practice agriculture, or from where they will get food to eat, from where they will get, so basically we also depend on our farmers, it is a link. We depend on our farmers, they produce and we eat. So same way, if the soil is poor, if agricultural will not be practiced in that area, it is going to affect not only the farmers, not only the agricultural pattern of that area, but also all the people, those who are linked with that. So drought condition is due to the high temperature. If the temperature is very hot, if the area is not receiving proper rainfall, a proper amount of area, that area's land will be very infertile. So next point is, we have discussed about the four points, then inaccessibility means if you cannot access that place, if it is very difficult for you to reach to that place, you will not go for that. You will not go for the settlement in that area. So next point you can write is, inaccessibility to that place. So this was all the points what discouraged the population density, and this were the points which encourages the population density. Now in our next class, on the basis of these factors, we will discuss whether the population at that place is densely. Densely means very high population. Moderately means medium, neither very less nor very more. And then sparsely populated region, that means which will be having very less population. The settlement is very less over there. So there are three types of, you can say, population categorized under the population heading: densely, moderately, sparsely. So that we will be discussing in our next class. I hope you would have understood these points, revised these points. And that's all for today. Goodbye and have a nice day. Thank you.